My name is Adriana Rinsch. I'm the Managing Director of the Language Technology Center. We are innovators in multilingual technology and translation management workflow tools. And we have built a system for the medical domain, which you can see in the exhibition hall if you want a demo. I was chairing yesterday the panel on eye healthcare. We had a wide variety of options there, and it was very interesting to see how, if we combine everything that we discussed yesterday, all the systems together, we would have a very comprehensive offering and a tool which would help, or a set of tools which would help save costs and improve the services in the healthcare domain. Just to give you a few examples of what could be done, patient and clinical information management could be considerably improved, and hospitals could save a lot of money. Implementing these language technology options, there would be better treatment and fewer medical errors if language technology would be implemented. Past patient data could be mined for research purposes if they were in an appropriate digital format. And you can imagine that, for instance, prescription drug abuse could be tracked if people can be found who have submitted several prescriptions for the same purpose, going to several doctors, which would not be possible anymore if language technology could track these things. Better health monitoring would be another possibility. Then also we have multilingual technology aspects. Imagine medical tourism nowadays. People want to go and have their dental treatments in the cheapest area. The NHS sends patients for hip replacements to France. And if all the medical data required to perform such international healthcare tasks could be available in more than one language, that would be of great help. There's also now the possibility, there is a big project, EU-funded project, which pilots e-prescription services across the whole of Europe. And it means that when you come from Italy with your prescription, you can submit it in Greece and have the appropriate product, which may not have the same name, but the same substances. And this is also obviously a big advantage and could help save costs, returning people who have fallen ill in a foreign country home and all the other issues arising from something like that. We also have professionals working abroad and their healthcare records are not available at the moment. Duplication of work, duplication of notes, duplication of a lot of things is required. And then we have rare diseases where you have, rare diseases are rare, and it means you don't have enough cases in one country in order to carry out systematic research. So you need to collaborate with researchers in other countries, with you need to inform GPs and consultants in order to deliver effective treatments. And the patients also sometimes, in very rare diseases, you need to be able to communicate, or you want to have other patients and the experience of other patients, and you don't have it in the same country. So exchanging information is very important. So one aspect really is to save a lot of money by implementing language technology. The other aspect is a social aspect, helping communication at every level in the healthcare chain. And finally, we want to, we need to, in the next couple of years, make sure that the tools that we have, and which our panel showed yesterday, it is a fragmented situation, little tools in covering aspects of the requirements in the healthcare domain. They need to be put together, interfaced, and then we have excellent opportunities in this market. Thank you very much.